Thank you, Maurice. Now, ActionAid describes itself as a global movement of people working together to further human rights and defeat poverty for all. In Uganda, the civil society organization has been particularly vocal on corruption, starting campaigns such as the Black Monday movement and the Anti Corruption Caravan. The Eastern League of Action Aid Uganda's annual Anti Corruption Caravan starts soon, covering up to 10 districts with the aim of lifting the veil on the corrupt and encouraging naming and shaming. On Tech 5 tonight, we ask the Director of Partnerships and Fundraising at Action Aid Uganda, Henry Nickson Ogwal, whether this isn't an exercise in futility. Do join the conversation on Facebook, Twitter, and SMS. Our hashtag is NTVTech5. You can get us on our Facebook page, NTV Uganda fan page, or our SMS number, which is 6565. Remember to begin with Tech5. Welcome to NTV.
Thank you, Rachel.
All right. Let's start with how the public has responded. And we do have a question from one of our viewers, Kaviri Ali, on a Twitter platform. He's asking, how has the public responded to this call? Have you registered any key achievements?
Yes, this is the second league of the anti-corruption caravan. Last year in December, we had the northern section of it. We covered 12 districts, and the public responded very well indeed, because of the awareness that it really raised. A number of corruption cases were reported by the local people. We are very glad that actually the police even took action to start registering of those cases, and follow-up have been made. But I think there is need for further action. For the case of this year's League of the Northeastern Eastern Uganda Anti-Corruption Caravan, people are geared up, right from Kotido down to Iganga. That's about 15 districts. People are ready, they're waiting, they're asking for the date, the event locations and all that. We are working with 15 organizations in those districts, and all that they're telling us is that people are waiting.
People are waiting. Yes. Speaking of people waiting, one of your objectives is to encourage naming and shaming. How has that worked out for you?
Well, there are actually two positive actions that we are calling citizens' positive actions. Positive actions, these are actions of the citizens backed up by their constitutional mandate to fight corruption. The first and foremost, this time round, we are encouraging people to come out and name those who are doing rightful things, so that those become the fame people with integrity, so that they become examples. The other is actually to name those who are stealing, the thieves of the opportunities and resources of this nation, so that we do two things. We are going to launch what we call the virtual citizens prison, so they will we will have their lists. At least that is what the citizens can do.
Then we leave
others for the institutions that can try out. There will be a lot of collection of evidence from the local people. So if those evidence are backed up, we will hand them over to IGG and other institutions that are mandated to fight corruption. So those are actually the things that we will be doing across those 15 districts.
Let me just read one of our viewers' comments. We have one here from Cinderella and then on Twitter, who says, it's not a futile attempt, but rather not easily understood by all at the grassroots. It needed the one step at a time move. Do you think there's a flaw in your strategy, or a way in which maybe people don't understand what your objectives are, what your aims are?
Thank you very much for that comment, that it's not a futile. But second part of the question is, it's probably what the viewer knows about what we do on ground. When we say we're working with 15 different local organizations across those 15 districts, it means that on a day-to-day basis, they're actually creating understanding of the people on the dangers of corruption in terms of how it affects service delivery. They are the people who know it best. The 20 women who are dying giving birth every day in Uganda are from those communities. So we make a linkage to bigger issues like tax revenue collection. We say people must pay their tax. We reach them like that. And then follow up on your tax to see that services are delivered. So there's no flaw. Only that when we are doing now the caravan to collect the evidence and the names and this kind of voting by the people, by the citizens, the people at Kampala think that it is just a one day's event. It's not. It's everyday life.
Let's just end on the note of, you know, the people in Kampala. I'm running out of time, but I just quickly want you to comment on the laxity of, especially the people in, you know, in Kampala, in the city. Usually on the black, during the Black Monday campaigns, you just have a handful of people who are more vocal about, you know, your views and your objectives as ActionAid. How can we, all of us, you know, get engrossed or embrace this campaign to fight graft in our country?
I think the best is what we are doing, is changing the public opinion in terms of understanding the dangers of corruption, and that every citizen should know that it's their mandate to actually fight corruption. And it is only when they do that and come, what we are saying is stop the silence, shame the thieves, but at the same time, name those who are doing rightful things.
So
that the morals of the people will convict them. That's very important. Secondly, we should also ensure that the institutions to fight corruption are strengthened and action, political action, are taken.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Ogwal. Unfortunately, that's all the time we had for this discussion. Been talking to Mr. Henry Nickson Ogwal, the Director of Partnerships and Fundraising at ActionAid Uganda.